friend.
Let us share in the prayer of the day together. O God of mercy and might, in the mystery of the passion of your Son, you offer your infinite life to the world. Gather us around the cross of Christ and preserve us until the resurrection. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please remain standing as you are able and let us sing our song of praise, Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone.
Thank you.
You may be seated for the reading of Scripture.
The first reading is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 15, verses 4 through 9a. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with the word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me, who will declare me guilty. Second reading is in the book of Philippians, chapter 2, verses 5 through 11. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
One of the 12, who was called Judas Iscariot, went to the chief priests and said,
"What will you give me if I betray him to you?"
They paid him 30 pieces of silver, and from that moment he began to look for an opportunity to betray him. On the first day of unleavened bread, the disciples came to Jesus, saying, "Where do you want us to make preparations for you to eat the Passover?" He said,
"Go into the city to a certain man and say to him, 'The teacher says, my time is near. I will keep the Passover at your house with my disciples.'"
So the disciples did as Jesus had directed them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When it was evening, he took his place with the 12, and while they were eating, he said,
"Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me."
And they became greatly distressed and began to say to him, and one after another, "Surely not I, Lord." He answered,
"The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of God goes as it is written of him, but woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born."
Judas, who betrayed him, said,
"Surely not I, Rabbi."
"You have said so."
While they were eating, Jesus took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to the disciples, and said,
"Take, eat, this is my body."
Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, saying,
"Drink from it, all of you. For this is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. I tell you, I will never again drink of this fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new with you in my Father's kingdom."
When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them,
"You will all become deserters because of me this night, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee."
Peter said to him,
"Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you."
"Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times.
"Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you."
And so said all the disciples. Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I go over there and pray."
He took with him Peter and the 2 sons of Zebedee and began to be grieved and agitated. Then he said to them,
"I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here and stay awake with me."
And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed,
"My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet not what I want, but what you want."
Then he came to the disciples and found them sleeping. And he said to Peter,
"So, could you not stay awake with me 1 hour? Stay awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak."
Again, he went away for a second time and prayed,
"My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done."
Again, he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were heavy. So, leaving them again, he went away and prayed for the 3rd time, saying the same words. Then he came to the disciples and said to them,
"Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? See, the hour is at hand, and the Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners. Get up, let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived with him. It was a large crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had given them a sign saying,
"The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him."
At once he came up to Jesus and said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus said to him,
"Friend, do what you are here to do."
Then they came and laid hands on Jesus and arrested him. Suddenly, one of those with Jesus put his hand on his sword, drew it, and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to him,
"Put your sword back into its place, for all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Do you think that I cannot appeal to my Father, and he will once send me more than 12 legions of angels? How then would the scriptures be fulfilled, which say it must happen in this way?"
At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds,
"Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me as though I were a bandit? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But all this has taken place so that the scriptures of the prophets may be fulfilled."
Then all the disciples deserted him and fled. Those who had arrested Jesus took him to Caiaphas, the high priest, in whose house the scribes and the elders had gathered. But Peter was following him at a distance, as far as the courtyard of the high priest, and going inside, he sat with the guards in order to see how this would end. Now the chief priests and the whole council were looking for false evidence against Jesus so that they might put him to death, but they found none, though many false witnesses came forward. At last, two came forward and said,
"This fellow said, 'I am able to destroy the temple of God and to build it in 3 days.'"
The high priest stood up and said,
"Have you no answer? What is it that they testify against you?"
But Jesus was silent. Then the high priest said to him,
"I put you under oath before the living God. Tell us if you are the Messiah, the Son of the living God."
"You have said so. But I tell you, from now on you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of power and coming on the clouds of heaven."
Then the high priest tore his clothes and said,
"He has blasphemed. Why do we still need witnesses? You have now heard his blasphemy. What is your verdict?"
"He deserves death." Then they spat on his face and struck him, and some slapped him, saying,
"Prophesy to us, you Messiah. Who is it that struck you?"
Now Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard. A servant girl came to him and said,
"You also were with Jesus the Galilean."
But he denied it before all of them, saying,
"I do not know who you are talking about."
When he went out to the porch, another servant girl saw him, and she said to the bystanders,
"This man was with Jesus of Nazareth."
Again, he denied it with an oath,
"I do not know the man."
After a little while, the bystanders came up and said to Peter,
"Certainly, you are one of them, for your accent betrays you."
Then he began to curse, and he swore an oath,
"I do not know the man."
At that moment, the cock crowed. Then Peter remembered what Jesus had said, "Before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. And he went out and wept bitterly. When morning came, all the chief priests and elders of the people conferred together against Jesus in order to bring about his death. They bound him, led him away, and handed him over to Pilate, the governor. When Judas, his betrayer, saw that Jesus was condemned, he repented and brought back the 30 pieces of silver to the chief priests and elders, and he said,
"I have sinned by betraying innocent blood.
What is that to us? See to it yourself."
Throwing down the pieces of silver in the temple, he departed. And he went and hanged himself. But the chief priest, taking the pieces of silver, said,
"It is not lawful to put them into the treasury, since they are blood money."
After conferring together, they used them to buy the potter's field in a place to bury foreigners. For this reason, that field has been called the field of blood to this day. Then was fulfilled what they had spoken through the prophet Jeremiah. And they took the 30 pieces of silver, the price of the one on whom the price had been set, on whom some of the people of Israel had set a price, and they gave them for the potter's field, as the Lord commanded me. Now Jesus stood before the governor, and the governor asked him,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
"You say so."
But when he was accused by the chief priests and the elders, he did not answer. Then Pilate said to him,
"Do you not hear how many accusations they make against you?"
But he gave him no answer, not even to a single charge, so that the governor was greatly amazed. Now, at the festival, the governor was accustomed to release a prisoner for the crowd, anyone whom they wanted. At that time, they had a notorious prisoner called Jesus Barabbas. So, after they had gathered, Pilate said to them,
"Whom do you want me to release for you, Jesus Barabbas or Jesus, who is called the Messiah?"
For he realized that it was out of jealousy that they had handed him over. While he was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent word to him, "Have nothing to do with that innocent man, for today I have suffered a great deal because of a dream about him." Now the chief priests and the elders persuaded the crowds to ask for Barabbas and to have Jesus killed. The governor again said to them,
"Which of the two do you want me to release for you?"
"Barabbas."
"Then what should I do with Jesus, the one called the Messiah?"
"Let him be crucified."
"Why? What evil has he done?"
"Let him be crucified." So, when Pilate saw that he could do nothing, but rather a riot was beginning, he took some water and washed his hands before the crowd, saying,
"I am innocent of this man's blood. See to it yourselves."
Then the people as a whole answered,
"His blood be on us and our children."
So he released Barabbas for them, and after flogging Jesus, he handed him over to be crucified. Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the governor's headquarters. They gathered the whole cohort around him. They stripped him and put a scarlet robe on him, and after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on his head. They put a reed in his right hand and knelt before him and mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" They spat on him and took the reed and struck him on the head. After mocking him, they stripped him of the robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him away to crucify him. As they went out, they came upon a man from Cyrene named Simon. They compelled this man to carry his cross. And when they came to a place called Golgotha, which means place of the skull, they offered him wine to drink mixed with gall. But when he tasted it, he would not drink it. And when they had crucified him, they divided his clothes among themselves by casting lots. Then they sat down there and kept watch over him. Over his head, they put a charge against him which read, "This is Jesus, the King of the Jews." Then two bandits were crucified with him, one on his right and one on his left. Those who passed by derided him, shaking their heads and saying,
"You who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself. If you are the Son of God, come down from the cross."
In the same way, the chief priests also, along with the scribes and elders, were mocking him, saying,
"He saved others, but he can't save himself. He is the King of Israel. Let him come down from the cross now, and we will believe in him. He trusts in God. Let God deliver him now, if he wants to. For he said, 'I am God's son.'"
The bandits who were crucified with him also taunted him in the same way. From noon on, darkness came over the whole land until 3 in the afternoon. And at about 3 o'clock, Jesus cried with a loud voice,
"Eli, Eli lama sabachthani."
That is, my God, why have you forsaken me?" When some of the bystanders heard it, they said,
"This man is calling for Elijah."
At once, one of them ran and got a sponge, filled it with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it to him to drink. But the others said,
"Wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him."
Then Jesus cried again with a loud voice and breathed his last. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook, and the rocks were split. The tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. After his resurrection, they came out of the tombs and entered the holy city and appeared to many. Now, when the centurion and those with him who were keeping watch over Jesus saw the earthquake and what took place, they were terrified and said,
"Truly, this man was God's son."
Many women were also there, looking on from a distance. They had followed Jesus from Galilee and provided for him. Among them were Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of the sons of Zebedee. When it was evening, there came a rich man from Arimathea named Joseph, who was also a disciple of Jesus. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. Then Pilate ordered it to be given to him. So Joseph took the body and wrapped it in a clean linen cloth and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had hewn from the rock. Then he rolled then a great stone to the door of the tomb and went away. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were sitting there opposite the tomb. The next day, that is the day after preparation, the chief priests and the Pharisees gathered before Pilate and said,
"Sir, we remember what this impostor said while he was still alive. After 3 days, I will rise again. Therefore, command the tomb to be made secure until the third day. Otherwise, his disciples may go and steal him away and tell the people he has been raised from the dead. And the last deception would be worse than the first."
Pilate said to them,
"You have a guard of soldiers. Go, make it as secure as you can."
So they went with the guard and made the tomb secure by sealing the stone.
continue with the offering of our gifts and our tithes, and also our children's noisy offering. Please stand as you are able. Thank you. Let us join our hearts in a word of prayer. Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Lord, is our cry today, meaning save us. Turn our hearts and our eyes and our minds to you this week. Help us to make that journey beside you and all the way until the cross. As we eagerly await to hear the dawning of Easter morn and that incredible news of the angels, he is not here, for he is risen. For all these things, we give you our thanks and praise in the name of Jesus, who teaches us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us sing our sending hymn.
We would invite any of the children in the church to come join us as we sing this little light of mine. They did such a great job a few weeks ago. We'd like to hear them again.
and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please head down to the fellowship hall for a breakfast put on by our youth.